KPFA, KPFB in Berkeley, or KFCF in Fresno, or on the web at kpfa.org. It's 7 p.m. Up next, Full Circle with a special remote broadcast from Live Oak High School in Antioch. Stay tuned.
All right, welcome everyone to Full Circle, your cultural affairs radio magazine. Produced by apprentices of the First Voice Media Action Program. And we're coming to you here live tonight from Live Oak High School. Yeah. We're here in downtown Antioch, and graduation is in the air all over the Bay Area. And tonight we have a very special show for you. We'll be talking with principals and teachers, past and present. We'll learn how to get a community college education from Marco Godinez, counselor at Las Vegas Community College. And we'll also have student guest hosts, student commentaries, and much more. I'm Freewill and Franklin, and I'll be your MC for tonight. Stay with us. All right, welcome back, everyone. This is Freewill and Franklin. We're here at Live Oak High School, directly across the street from Antioch High School, where I graduate, or where, like some of us, we started at Antioch High School, but we all come to Live Oak and graduate here. And either out of choice or necessity, either one. And Live Oak is a continuation high school. It was founded in 1971, somewhere around there, maybe 72. It was grown out of the REACH project, and part of their mission is to provide students with an opportunity to graduate and acquire the necessary knowledge and skills to become economically independent. And personally, what I really remember about Live Oak is here they give you the attention that you need, the personal attention you need to get your credits to graduate on time, or as close to on time as you can. And one of the people that helped me get my diploma and earn my education is sitting right here next to me. His name is Keith Edwards. Welcome, Keith.
Frank, it's nice to be here. Again.
Keith's coming back out of his first year of retirement. Thanks for coming. Keith, you've been here since the very beginning of Live Oak. Probably you've been teaching over 30 years affiliated with Live Oak. Is that right?
Yes, that's right, Frank.
And so as the beginning, in the beginning when Live Oak started, why did you feel it was so important for a school like Live Oak to exist?
I think everybody needs to have a place where they're valued, where they can actually connect with a learning experience that's really positive. My first year in about 1972, I was working for REACH, and I was actually in a casual conversation with a 17-year-old young lady. I never forgot this. You know, it's sort of, she asked me, well, why are you teaching? Why are you teaching here? And I kind of paused and I looked at her and I said, why are you asking that? I said, because this is, you know, actually, it's fun. I enjoy being with you and I enjoy doing this teaching experience here. And she said, well, I always thought that people went into teaching because they hated kids. And she was like dead serious. This is like a 17-year-old girl. And to me, the idea of taking a young person and actually getting them in a position where they can feel confident about themselves, about their abilities, and make them feel that they can actually have a future, that they can be socially connected, economically viable, and, you know, feel that life has a lot of opportunities out there for them, it's really important, I think, to create a learning environment where people with that kind of a background and that kind of outlook have.
Very good. Thank you, Keith. And when I was a student here at Live Oak, you might remember, I wasn't taking my education too seriously. And I regret that a little bit, but like a lot of students, they might not be taking their education too seriously. How did you find the gumption or whatever to keep teaching when all around you students might not really care too much about their education?
You know, there's an old phrase that goes along with teaching, and it's something about the art of good teaching is arousing curiosity in young minds. And I think that if you keep that focused. I mean, I think it's such a natural instinct in young people. They're naturally curious. And if you're able to impart lessons, instruction, a classroom setting that continually makes students curious about learning and curious about their environment, I mean, you're going to be successful. I always felt that teaching was fun. Administration was work, but teaching was fun.
All right. Thank you, Keith, again. And I want to just give you a special thanks for sticking by us and sticking by me personally, because I remember the donut story. One time I came to school really late, and I happened to have a sack of donuts with me. And Keith was my first period teacher, and he gave me a little lecture about coming to school late with donuts again. But now that we got him back, and he's here back at Live Oak, I wanted him to present him with this special certificate of appreciation for sticking by the students of Live Oak and me personally. So thank you, Keith, for sticking by me.
You're welcome, Frank. And by the way, those donuts were very good.
So thanks for coming out tonight, and thank you for my education.
Yeah, you're welcome.
And also, I wanted to ask you before we go that there is a scholarship awarded in your name. You want to tell us about how this developed and what it's all about?
You know, you kind of got me on that one. I'm not quite sure exactly where this is coming from, except for the fact that I do think that any scholarship that's offered to Live Oak High School students, and we've had, you know, many over the years, are usually given to students who otherwise really wouldn't consider going to school to further their education after high school. So this is a very important kickstart for students, especially if they're going on to junior college and possibly, you know, four universities.
All right. Thank you, Keith. Stay with us, because I'm about to introduce another fellow sitting here, Mr. John Jimno. He's the current principal of the school. He's right here, the guy at the headphones, which was a bunch of them. But, John, how's it feel to be here? I wanted to ask you, how do you feel replacing Keith Edwards? Some big shoes to fill?
Very big shoes to fill. Almost impossible shoes to fill. But I knew the day that I heard he was retiring, I knew this was my job. I knew it from, you know, the start of when it was posted for the district, that I knew that I had to be in this position. It was meant for me. The one thing I was comfortable with coming in is I had the fundamental philosophy that I shared with Keith, is that I believe in the program, I believe in the structure, and I also believe in the students that go here. So I knew that with that philosophy, I couldn't fail. It could only just enhance what he's done and try to make it better.
Okay, now I just want to mention that recent study that came out about students have not increased much in their education at the high school level since about the 70s. What are you guys doing at Live Oak to try to be an exception to this rule?
Well, we're in a data-driven society now, so we're trying to use that to look at what we do well with students, and not use data to drive what we do, but look at what our students do, what our teachers do really well, and how we work with students, and then use the data to support what the efforts we're trying to do. We have specific strategies to work with our students, and we try to really give them the feeling that it's an individual plan for each student. And we're just really trying to work on how we collaborate together to provide the best atmosphere for our kids.
All right, and this can go for either Keith or for John. The high school is directly across the street from us, Antioch High School, which is a school where there's thousands of students. There are hundreds at least. How does the education here at Live Oak compare to the education across the street at Antioch High School? John?
I think that the individual attention and approach, and I think Keith touched on it earlier, in just having a place where kids feel they're valued, their voices heard, they feel important and connected to the school. And sometimes in the big high schools that we have, kids get lost. And I think the important thing when they come here, they're able to find themselves again and find a plan that they can follow and find some success with.
All right. And before I let you guys go, do you guys have any last words for students out there that are trying to graduate? Let's go with John first.
I would say that start now, don't wait. You know, I think the biggest problem students have sometimes is they always think that they have time, and there's no time like now.
And Keith, you got any last words for them students out there?
Things can be pretty difficult at times, and you think that it's not worth it, and you get really down on yourself, but never give up. Just focus on getting through, and if you can't do it right this very moment, just make sure that you continue forward at some time, at some point.
All right, thank you guys. And so a part of this project tonight to come out and do a show at Live Oak was to reach back to the community where I came from. I'm a member of the KPFA apprenticeship program, And that's part of their mission, is to reach back to where you came from. So that's why I'm here. And Keith, you're a part of that. Thank you for getting me here.
You're welcome, Frank. It's good to see you back at Live Oak, giving something back to the school. Pretty neat stuff.
All right. Well, thanks for making that happen. And thank you. Thank you. And another part of this project tonight was to have students participate. And as you'll hear tonight, we're going to have student commentaries. And we have special student hosts that are joining us. And we have two of them here with us now. And John, Jim Noe, the principal, is going to introduce these guest hosts. Tell us who we got here.
I'm very excited to have two of our seniors here tonight. We have Kayla Borromeo and we have Rogelio Acosta. Both of them are seniors here. They are part of our leadership team at Live Oak, and they are also on pace to graduate this year.
All right. So this is Kayla right here.
Hey, everybody.
And that's Rogelio sitting next to him.
Hey.
And so welcome, Kayla and Rogelio. And they've been putting up with my stuff for a couple weeks now, a couple months, and I want to thank you guys for participating. And they have our first guest joining us. You guys want to talk about who we got joining us?
Yeah. Thank you, Frank. We're here tonight with Marco Gordinez. He's a counselor at Los Medanos Community College in Pittsburgh. He grew up in Antioch and is a graduate of Antioch High School. A lot of Live Oak students attend LMC to earn credits to graduate, and some plan on attending after graduation. And he's here tonight to help us learn how we can get a college education. Welcome, Marco. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me here today at good old Antioch. So with my good friend John Jimno, went to school with him. So, yeah, I can tell you a little bit how to get to LMC. Community college is an open-door access. It's a great thing about Los Medanos College or any community college. Only thing you got to do is put your application in, and you're in. So come and talk to the counselors. I think there's a lot of opportunities.
Hey, Marco. My first question was there any experience from your high school that led you to this job helping out high school or college students?
I'm a first-generation college student, non-traditional. What that means is, like, you know, no one in my family went to college. So what kind of provided me and was kind of the catalyst for me to go to college, I went to LMC, started taking classes, just wanted my AA degree, and then had some good mentors that told me I can go on. Mm-hmm. And I got my bachelor's degree at Cal State Hayward at the time. Now it's called East Bay. And then I got my master's degree at John F. Kennedy. And what kind of led me to get into this job was not knowing the system. And when I understood it, made me want to go back. So I wanted to go back to the college I started. Just like Frank, you know, he's came out here, learned about, you know, radio, and then he wanted to come back. Same thing with me. I wanted to go back and give to my community and start talking about how to go to college. Mm-hmm. And what it's all about.
Well, that's great. A question I wanted to ask is, what is one of the most common problems that high school and college students face starting school or even during school that you have to help them with?
Ooh, that's a good question, a really good question. I think people don't know the system. They think it's impossible. And when I say impossible is when they don't understand how the system works, they get lost, they give up. So one thing, especially growing up in East County, I think we do everything by relations. And when I talking about relations is by, we need somebody to kind of talk to, hey, how does this work? Can I trust you? Can I understand how this whole system works? So I think the biggest thing is when students don't know how to put an application in, what their options are, what's the difference from a community college, state college, UC, or private. When students start to understand the differences, it makes it a little easier for them to go to school.
Yeah.
What's the difference between a community college education and a university college?
Another good education question. You guys are doing some good works here at Live Oak. I like that.
Thank you.
The difference is a community college is a two-year school. When I mean two-year school, they do their freshman, sophomore, if you're thinking about going on to a university. And if you go on to a university, you can transfer to a state, private, and also UC system, those three, or even out of state. The community college is kind of like two colleges in one. Transfer into a university, or you can do what's called vocational. That means you can do like nursing, automotive, welding, anything that's kind of hands-on, but they call it smart tech today. So it's a two college in one. So those are the kind of the difference.
Okay. And if someone is in need of your services, how can they get a hold of you?
Two ways to get a hold. Well, there's actually three ways. Maybe even four ways. One way you can call up Los Redondos College, my number is 925-439-2181, extension 3350. That's my personal line, my work line. Another way is to call up my secretary, once again, 439-2181, extension 3334, so via phone. The second way is to get a hold of me via email, mgodinas@losredondos.edu, or swing on by. One thing I'm proud about at MC, we have an open-door policy. Come on by, talk. I think from our president to administration, even people that work as janitors, a lot of them are from the community. Peter Garcia is our current president right now, and he's a local boy. He's from Pittsburgh, and everybody knows him. You shake his hand, what's up, Pete? And he has open-door policy. He's real good folks. And myself, I'm a local boy, so I say anybody knows John Gemno, a friend of mine, you can swing on by.
Well, thank you, Marco. Again, Marco is a counselor at LMC.
Thanks, Marcos.
Thank you.
Coming up next, we have our first commentary by John Mixon.
John is a senior at Live Oak High School. As you will hear, he had quite a journey struggling to rise up and graduate.
I started high school at Antioch High with so many requirements, so many obstacles, so many more distractions and high expectations all at the same time. Freshman year, I got into a few confrontations, many compliments, and also sports. I stopped playing sports because my grades started to drop and I started to slack off. Not in class, but my homework. I never did it because I felt everything else was more important to me. 10th grade, I started off good up until I came across a misunderstanding with my teacher and caused me to get kicked out of class and the following days after that class for no reason. And when I finally asked why, she told me she didn't like me. I tried to switch my class after talking to my counselor and she told me no. So I got the impression that I was being set up to fail. In the middle of that year, I got into an incident which led me to transferring out the district. 11th grade, I returned back to the district starting at Antioch High with 55 credits. I should have had at least 120 as a junior. I was working hard and doing all my work when the incident came back up and I had to leave again with anger, stress, depression, no hope, love, or happiness in my life, which had either jail or death in my future. So I knew I had to get it together. I had one more year to go. Starting at Live Oak, my 12th grade year gave me another opportunity, but I still was far behind, starting with 92 credits, and I should have had at least 180. I started at Los Redondos College, which I passed all my classes with 23 out of 23 credits, with a confident head on my shoulders. I was trying to push it to the limit, and one day Mr. Gemno called me in the office and ripped up my contract and said, "Mr. Mixon, graduation is a for sure thing if you earn all your credits for fourth quarter." I told myself, I'm not going to fall off. I'm going to stick to my plan. I told myself, graduation ain't here yet, but I know for a well-known fact I will be walking that stage for class 09.
All right, everybody, let's hear it for John Mixon. So we were welcoming John tonight to be with us, but I don't think he made it on time. So John's going to graduate this year. You heard in his commentary that he was pushing it, and he's going to make it. So big hand for John Mixon one more time. And I'm going to turn it back over to Kayla and Rahelio. I think they're going to say goodbye. And before they do, they want to say something else. But you guys have anything to say? I want to thank you guys, actually, for helping tonight and putting up with all my stuff. Is there any words you want to say to the listeners out there?
Thank you for tuning in. And this has been Kayla.
Thanks for tuning in. Stay in school. This is Rogelio.
And before we go, we want to throw it over to Zach Kalam with his friends from Antioch High School Drumline. Good night, everybody. Zach, take it away.
All right. Antioch High School Drumline. All right. Welcome back, everyone. This is Full Circle on 94.1 KPFA. We're live in Antioch at Live Oak High School. And that excellent drumline performance you just heard was from the Antioch High School Drumline. And I want to thank Zach Kalau for bringing his friends out tonight. Thank you, Zach. He's our connection to the school across the street because we're sharing the love with Antioch High School tonight across the street. And now I want to introduce my next two brave souls that have come to help host tonight. We got, that's Javier Gomez. And that next to him is Oscar the fire-breathing Mondragon. How you guys doing tonight?
We're doing good.
Oh, man, we're doing good.
All right, so I want to thank you guys for coming out tonight and putting up with my stuff like the rest of them for the last couple months. And tell me a little bit about yourselves. You guys are attending school. Let's start with you, Oscar.
Yes, my name is Oscar Mondragon. I'm a senior here at Live Oak High School. I'm 17 years old. This is my second year attending here.
And Javier?
Oh, my name's Javier, and I'm 18. I'm a senior here at Live Oak, and this is my first year here.
Yeah. All right. Well, thanks for coming again. And these two guys here are going to interview our next guest who's sitting next to him. I'll just turn it over to you guys. You guys take it over and tell us who's with you.
All right. Thanks, Frank. Well, we're right here with Mr. Haymeyer. He's one of the teachers here at Live Oak, and he teaches U.S. history, world history, and economics. And he's one of the well-liked teachers here at Live Oak, and rumor has it that he could throw down in the kitchen.
One of many.
Hey, you know.
Welcome, Mr. Haymeyer.
Hey, thanks for having me, guys.
Yeah. And Mr. Amar, well, the question that everybody wants to ask is, what gets you to school besides the paycheck?
Wow, it's definitely not the paycheck, guys. it's coffee, actually. No, it's really you guys. It's the students. You know, when students first come over here, it feels like they kind of get sent into the corner of the district. And we like it when we get some great human beings like you guys who we see their potential. That you guys come in and you do some wonderful things. You're doing a radio show right now. I don't know many students in Antioch that are doing a radio show right now. Yeah. So, pretty impressive.
Yeah, so the other question that I wanted to ask you is, what is it that you like about here specifically from any other school that's different?
What I love about Live Oak, and you know, since I've started here, right off the bat, it is we are a community. We are a small community that we care about each other, right? We are parents, we are students, we are staff, and we all are doing it together, and, you know, we pick each other up along the way, but we never let each other fall, and it's pretty cool what we're doing here at our little school.
Now, a lot of people say that Live Oak is just for kids that have problems and for bad kids. Now, what would you have to say to those people that say that?
They're wrong. Live Oak is a wonderful school with a lot of great kids. Who, for whatever reason, for many reasons, kind of get lost along the way. And Live Oak, you guys come here, and we see what you really have. You have that potential that I was talking about, and you know, you show us that you are bright individuals who have futures, and that you're going to do something with yourselves. So a lot of people outside of Live Oak think that, oh, this is the school for the bad kids. We don't know, you know, we don't want to have anything to do with them. But if they came over here and saw what you guys were doing, they'd be very, very impressed.
Yeah, and you as you're teaching overall, what is it that you do that keeps students focused and active in class? How is it that you keep them active?
I get it. You guys are, I'm asking this to you, back to you, you guys are focused in class.
Oh, yeah.
That's amazing.
Then you always pay attention.
That means a lot to me. My first year, fireworks, I guess, I couldn't do. So they said no fireworks.
maybe next year.
And I'm too lazy to learn magic. So I guess I try to stick to humor. I try to make you guys laugh. You know, you get the kids to laugh, get them involved, get a smile on their face, and it seems like they're more willing to follow along and pay attention in class.
And how do you do all this and keep them active and still find time to teach the standard test and teach in your own creative way?
Well, you know, it's not that hard. All of us teachers, we take, you know, it's important to do the standards thing. The state standards, we got to do it. It's part of teaching. But we know that the creativity will come. You just have to put in the extra time. So, you know, whatever we're doing. If I do some lame rap or whatever we're doing, we have fun doing it. Or a video or whatever, we're having fun, but we're still hitting those standards that we have to do because it's our jobs.
Well, thanks for everything, and we have to say goodbye to you now, but is there anything you want to say?
Actually, before you let him go, let me ask him a question. How do you feel about those standardized tests? Does that impede your teaching, or do you feel like you're free to teach what you want to teach?
Well, Franklin, the standardized tests are great.
Come on, you can let it go. You can let it go.
Oh, this is free speech radio. Yeah. You know, the standardized tests are what they are, and we have them. They do inhibit some of the things we would like to do as teachers, but we know they're there, and we teach to them, but it is not. I do not teach the test, but I feel that I still hit the standards that they need to know to be successful on the test while, you know, we're still doing our school thing, having fun. So it's not the only deal.
And a minute ago, Javier mentioned the video that you did. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that propaganda video that you made?
Oh, wow. The propaganda video was something that came up. We did. We had a world history class, and we were learning about propaganda. And I gave them the opportunity to make a propaganda commercial for their own countries. We called it Great Land and Strong Land. And each side of the class had their own country that they had to create a little propaganda for. So we created our own little radio commercial, and I had some help from the staff. Mr. Hayes was a news anchor, one of our teachers here. Anytime I can put some wigs on some of my fellow workers, it's fun to do. So it was a lot of fun, and I think we all got involved, and they really enjoyed the whole experience. It was a good time.
All right, thank you. So I'll let you turn it back over to you guys. You go, and we have a commentary coming up.
Well, next we have a commentary by Janelle Frazier.
Yes, Johnnie is a senior here at Live Oak, but only been here for 1 year. She's 17 years old, and here's her story.
It all started when I was a freshman in high school. I never thought this journey would have so many twists and turns and ups and downs. Ever since I was a freshman, it was very hard for me to get focused because it seemed like school had no place in my life. I was jumping from school to school, not really having any true friends and no one to talk to. My freshman and sophomore years were a waste. I had lots of built-up anger and personal issues from my home life that caused me to be unsuccessful in school. My sophomore year, I just didn't care about anything, not even myself. School wasn't the first thing on my mind. I just wanted to leave home. I found myself asking God, why am I here? There's no purpose for me. Then that's when a voice said, you have to care about yourself and do better for yourself, not anyone else. Then from that day forward, I tried to do better, and I gave up. Then something else happened. We had to move from Oakland to Antioch. I didn't want to, but I knew we had to. By the time I was a junior and was almost on track, I knew I had to go to Live Oak High School so I can get on track and graduate on time. So by my senior year, I was at Live Oak High School, and good news is I'm graduating on time. It wasn't easy. It took a lot of work, but I did it. This was a long road, but I know that I am just now getting started.
All right, everybody, let's give a big hand for Janelle Frazier. And I want to thank Janelle for spending the time to record that commentary. She spent a lot of time here with me. And so welcome back, everyone. This is Full Circle. It's 94.1 KPFA. And we are here again at Live Oak High School in Antioch. And that, like I said, that was Janelle Frazier, and that was her commentary. But I'm going to turn it back over to our guest host, Javier, and Oscar the Fire-Breathing Mondragon. They have a special student here who struggled to get to graduation like I did. I started Antioch High School. I ended up dropping out and coming to Live Oak, and the teachers here really gave me the attention I needed to get me to graduate. And I believe Carlos has a similar story, and I'll turn it over to Javier and Oscar. You guys take it away.
Yeah, we're here with Carlos Beltran, a senior here at Live Oak High School. Carlos has been through a unique journey towards earning his diploma from being expelled place at Bridges Community Day School to now being the president of Live Oak Leadership Team. Carlos is 2 weeks away from fulfilling his goal of graduation. Welcome, Carlos.
Thank you.
And what would you say was the biggest turning point for you in school?
I would say, honestly, straight up, it would be bridges.
Yeah.
Bridges was a thing that, you know, really changed me, you know. It really got me going with my credits, my work, my attitude, everything changed. So I would say bridges.
And what would you say to students that have the same problems and are in the same situation as you are now?
Don't make the same mistakes I did, because I struggled a lot. I went through a lot to get where I'm at right now. You know, tonight, honestly, I can't believe that graduation is happening. Like, maybe 2-3 years ago, I would have never seen myself graduating at all. You know, I'll probably not even make it to high school. You know, so this is something special for me right now.
Hey, let me butt in real quick. A lot of people around here might not know what Bridges is. I went to Live Oak. It was 20 years ago, but Bridges is right next door. A lot of people might not notice that blue building over there. Tell us a little bit about what Bridges is and what it did do for you.
Well, Bridges, it's not a regular school. You know, it's for expelled students, you know. We don't have the same opportunity as we have here in Live Oak or Antioch High School. It's not the same thing. We can't participate, like, in leadership. You know, we can't play sports. Well, we play sports PE, but it's not the same thing. We do work all day. We have a 30-minute break, which is PE, and then lunch. And that's pretty much it, you know. And everybody usually from Bridges usually has, like, a bad mood. So it's not a good environment to be in.
Everyone's in a bad mood in the Bridges, huh? All right, let me turn it back over to Javier. Sorry for interrupting you guys.
And another question is, what did you like most, and what will be the best memory you will take from your year at Live Oak?
From the beginning, you know, as soon as I started here, you know, all the teachers, all the staff, you know, I liked them all. There was not one of them that I didn't like, you know. Like every student, you know, they have the difficulties with some staffs, but, you know, I got through it with all, you know. I like all the teachers here, all the staff, my principal. You know, it's good to be in Live Oak. It's something I won't forget.
And what are your plans after graduation and leaving Live Oak?
My plan is to continue studying. I'm thinking of, you know, starting a career. You know, maybe most likely I am going to go to Wild Tech. You know, try to do some plumbing in there, because I have a couple friends that have a career in that. So hopefully, you know, I could get and join with them. You know, do something with my life. I don't want to be out here in the streets.
Yeah. Well, next we're going to take another short break with the Antioch High School Drumline. We'll be right back.
Thank you again. That's the Antioch High School drumline. I want to thank Nick Pitchner, Sabino Lopez, Zach Shonda, Zach Kalau, Jenny McCreary, and Terry Tonby. Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys. So that was the Antioch High School drumline, everyone. They come from across the street. Across the street. And now we have a very special guest, someone that's been here as long as I was here, when I was here, which was 89. And her name is Karen Spangler. How you doing, Karen?
I'm great. How are you?
Yeah, get a little closer to the mic.
Okay.
And so like I said, Karen was here back when I was here, which was 89. I graduated. What year was it you started?
88.
So I got her for 1 year. And all this time that you've been here, you're still here today. What is it about this school that you love so much?
Well, I love the kids here, and I love the program. I think that it's a unique setting for kids. It's the days of my days in school, you didn't have as many alternatives, and it's great that we now provide alternatives. All of us don't learn the same, and all of us don't have the same paths and same background. And Live Oak provides a path for many students that wouldn't otherwise be successful in school.
And I understand that you partake in some extracurricular activities around the school. What is it that you do on the weekends sometimes, or what is it that you fill your time with around the school besides just being here during the week?
Well, my passion is the kids and the getting them involved in everything, and I love Live Oak. Live Oak is a great place to work. One of the things that we do around here is we come down and have beautification days. The kids actually come out and staff and plant flowers and weed and do a lot of things that help to beautify our school. Our campus is one of the cleanest and most attractive in the school district. Many people are very surprised by the fact that we have roses and beautiful flowers and a well-kept and clean campus, whereas many campuses in our area aren't kept up quite that well.
So what is your particular interaction with the students? What about these two guys right here, Oscar Mondragon and Javier Gomez? What's your interaction with students? Do you talk to these guys much?
I do. They're great. They come in the office quite a bit. We have a lot of interaction with the students, both positive and sometimes not so positive. The cell phone action is pretty heavy at Live Oak, and it can lead to some dire consequences. And we get a lot of cell phones in the office, so that's a biggie. So not so much with these guys. They're pretty cool. And even the ones that bring the cell phones in are pretty cool kids. But I do get to see the kids on a regular basis, and that's one of the reasons that I like being at Live Oak. In some of the bigger schools that I've been at, my interaction with kids was minimal, and I really enjoy being in a campus where I can get to know these kids on a first-name basis, and they get to know me and my moods, and I do have them, and they know.
They have some moods, guys. You guys seem to have moods.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Thanks, Oscar, the fire-breathing dragon.
You've been here 20 years, over 20 years. What's the biggest change you've seen throughout these years?
I've been in the district for 25 years, and in 1988 I came here, and many of my friends thought I was crazy. And there are many misconceptions about our school, and up until now we've been kind of laying low and not letting people know how great a school it is, but tonight I think it's out of the bag. But Live Oak is a great school, and I've enjoyed it very, very much. And over the years, I've seen kids have changed a little, but not a lot. They're basically the same. Kids want to be recognized. They want to be known for who they are personally. And in a big campus, that doesn't happen a lot. You don't get to know the kids as well, and they don't get to know everyone else as well. And in our campus, that's the unique part of it. Students are known. Sometimes they'd like to be a little less known, because we kind of can see things coming and do some prevention work and then do some cleanup afterwards. But I think their character grows and swells here at Live Oak. And the beauty of being here for so long is I've seen many kids who are on a destructive path come here. And then years later, I've seen them pull up here in the summer when everybody's gone with their families, and they want to boast and show our campus off to their kids, who are now, one case this summer, they were coming from Florida. His kids were straight-A students going off to college, one of them, and he was proud. He was an electrical engineer, I believe, and he was very proud of the school that he'd gone to and what he had done with the information and the teaching that he got at this school. And I get to see that turnaround, and I love it. It's very, very good. Many, many times they come back to this school to share with us what's happened in their lives.
And here I am. I'm here back, and we have a lot of graduates from Live Oak. If you graduated from Live Oak, say what's up, everybody. Raise your hand. Oh, we got two or three. Okay. So we're getting ready to take a short music break, and then we're going to come back with Oscar and Javier and Mr. Jimno one more time. So let's take that music break. Welcome back. Y'all may hear that one. You guys know that one. The Rockin' Ramones with Rock and Roll High School. So, again, this is Full Circle. This is 94.1 KPFA, and we're out in Antioch at Live Oak High School. And there's a lot of graduates out here, and graduation, like I said, is in the air. And I'm still here joined by Oscar the Fire-Breathing Mondragon. What's up, Oscar?
Hey, what's up, man?
And I also got Javier Gomez. I almost forgot his name for a minute. And sitting next to them is John Jimno is back again. And I'm going to let these two guys have a shot at their principal for a minute on the air. So what is it
Be
you want to know about
boys.
This guy?
Graduation is still there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you haven't graduated yet, so be careful what you ask. You guys got some questions for him?
Actually, you know, let's try something different. Why don't I ask them a couple questions? You know, one of the things here that we're trying to do at Live Oak, first of all, I want to thank Full Circle and KPFA for letting us have this event today.
Yeah, Full Circle.
I want to thank all the great people for showing up out there tonight, past and present students, faculty, friends and family. Thank you guys for coming out. I want to thank my wife and my three kids and my mom and dad who are supporting the school tonight. So I appreciate that, you guys. And all the other family members that showed up for their students and staff. So part of the thing we're trying to do here at Live Oak is send the message of what we're doing to the greater community. KPFA and Full Circle has given us opportunity. But another thing is we want to channel our students and see what their experiences are. So a question I have for both of you guys could answer is, what do you find different about this school than your previous schools that you've been to that has turned you around?
Well, what's different, what's really a big difference from that high school, from the high school to this high school, is that over there you don't really get the attention that you need sometimes. So, and here it's like a big difference because, I mean, here you get all the attention you need. And, I mean, I personally have learned things that I didn't really, like, ever learn at the high school. So that's what's like a big, that's what's good about this school than Antioch.
Well, without putting any down, you know, the experience you have here at a smaller setting, is that what you feel is what turns you around is the fact that you have fewer staff to teacher ratio?
Yeah, and that's another thing because you get to like you get to interact better with your teachers. There's less people, so you get to know your teachers better than like at any you would at Antioch. So I personally think that it's that's why like you learn so many things and everything here.
And Javier, what would you respond to the same question? What have you what is you know some of the experience that you've enjoyed having since you've been here at a smaller campus like Live Oak?
Well, I gotta agree with Oscar. You know, the attention from the teachers is the best part because you know you learn more, and you can talk to them. And, you know, they help you out, and I think it's cool too that you know, like, so a little bit of people. You know, you can hang out some, and you know, you can be with your friends, but you also gotta study. You know.
So, what do you guys feel about the strict rules at Live Oak High School? Because, as you know, we are the hammer in the district. We should say, you know,
yeah.
Things that happen here cannot happen anywhere.
Yeah, because it's a big difference about like this school than any other school because the rules are so strict. You practically the first time I started going here, thought that like there were so many rules and everything. You know.
You know, actually, the first day before even school started, I got in trouble. You know, I didn't know it was that strict. You know.
I'd like to jump in on that too, because one thing I found about going to Live Oak, like they're all saying, is the special attention that you get here. Like when I introduced my former teacher Keith. It was Keith. It wasn't Mr. Edwards. We got to call our teachers by our first name. It really made you feel more comfortable knowing your teachers. And, like, it is a smaller school. How many students are here usually?
We have enrolled about 190 students, and we have two sessions. So there's usually about 90, right around there.
And in this setting, you get to know almost everyone around you. When I was at the high school, you could walk through, like John said, we want to put Antioch High School down. But walking through those halls, like, there's 1,000 people passing you. You never know who they are. I've only been coming back to the school for about a month and a half, and I know some of the people just from seeing them around, just for that short time, you really get to know the people around you, and that's what I felt was a real good benefit going here. And I wanted to just ask Javier and Oscar, because we're getting ready, we're getting close to wrapping it up, but what is your last words to any students out there that are trying to graduate and ain't quite there yet?
Oh, man, I think you should just keep trying and trying, because I personally thought, you know, I really thought I wasn't going to graduate and everything, you know, like, and I mean, I think you should just keep trying and trying, you know.
And Javier?
Well, just stay in school and just keep going at it, man. You know, no matter what happens, there's always another option that can help you
just
out.
Just keep pushing it.
Yeah, just don't give up.
And I understand you guys had a couple special shout-outs you wanted to do to your homies out there.
Yeah.
Go on, let it go, let it go.
Shout-out to KPFA 94.1. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming to DHB, Die Hard Boys. Yeah.
You know, and thanks for, you know, having us here, and shout out to the Die Hard Boys, you know,
DHB.
Shout out to my mama, to the family.
Get well.
You know.
I want to shout out to my mama, too.
Hey, my mama's out there, too. Mama, raise your hand. There's my mama.
A shout out to my wife.
All right.
Wherever she's at.
My wife is around here somewhere. Well, maybe she's not. Okay. All right. So we're starting to get close to the end of our show. I want to thank everybody for coming tonight. Give yourself all a big hand for showing up tonight. And so this is Full Circle. This is KPFA 94.1. And we're reaching back into our community during graduation time to share the air with the students and the people of Antioch. I don't know how many times KPFA's came to Antioch, but I'm going to keep bringing it back if I can find things to do. And before we let them go, I want to thank Javier and Oscar for showing up and actually doing this with me.
It was an
thanks
honor.
Thanks for having us.
It was an honor.
And I'm going to look forward to try to participate in Live Oak more. John Jimno said, wouldn't that be great if you were a teacher at Live Oak? I was like, dang. You never know.
Miracles can happen.
So that would bring it all around. We do have one more commentary lined up before we go, and you might recognize the voice. You guys had that ready for us? Okay, so earlier we had a guest host, and let's see if you can recognize this voice. Let's take that commentary. One more time.
Being able to graduate on time was one of the most exciting moments in my life to share with family and friends, but I couldn't do that without going to Live Oak High School. I think everybody forgets that it's a normal high school and that we get the same education as everybody else at any other high schools. Before going to Live Oak, I only knew about what I've heard. But now that I experienced going to Live Oak for a year, I'm happy to say that it's not about kids that get into trouble or without a care in the world, but students that are the same as you and I and are here because we want to graduate. I was nowhere close to graduating. I came to Live Oak with only 70 credits, and I was a senior. I needed 220 before June. Hearing that I wasn't going to graduate on time broke my heart, but I was only disappointed at myself. For 3 years, I wasn't taking my education serious, but there was no time for giving up. I wanted to graduate on time for me, and I wasn't going to lose faith until the day of graduation. I've learned that I wasn't going to graduate because I couldn't understand what was being taught, but I never gave myself the time to catch up in school when I was already behind. I just gave up. I was doing everything the opposite to getting me to graduation. Being so much behind in credits have taught me the biggest lesson that I had to overcome on my own. It wasn't easy taking so much extra classes and money I didn't have and taking twice as much time out and putting it into school. But I'm happy to say that it will all pay off at the end. I wish I had done things differently, but it only made me learn from my mistakes and that I was the only one that can turn it all around. If I graduate on time or not, it would still be as important. I think it's okay we all go through rough times in high school, but I only speak from experience. If you take your friends out of the picture, your family, boyfriend, or girlfriend, graduating is something for yourself, and nobody is worth taking away your education. For someone or something later in life, you'll regret. Graduating is something for yourself, for you to shine and for you to be proud of.
All right. Thank you, everyone. That was Kayla Baromeo. She's sitting right here. Kayla, how you doing? Oh, let's get that mic up one more time. Are you there? How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
So how did it feel to, how was it to do that commentary? Thanks for participating and putting up with all my text messages and my bugging you. How was it to share your story with everyone?
It felt good to know that, you know, that let other people know that they're not the only one that's struggling in high school, so...
And so how do you feel about the school Live Oak? Has it really helped you that much?
I love high school, Live Oak High School. I enjoy it. I like it better than Antioch. Hi.
Whoa, sorry. All right. We love Antioch High School too, but not as much as Live Oak, that's for sure.
Yeah.
So once again, I want to thank Kayla, Oscar, Javier, Oscar Mondragon, Zach Kalau, and the Antioch High School Drumline. And I wanted to thank them all for coming out. Let's give them all a big hand. And I want to give yourself all a big hand for coming out and coming to Live Oak tonight and participating in this live broadcast. This is our first remote broadcast. We're bringing the station out into the community, and this is our first attempt at it, and I'm glad you guys are all here to participate. Thank you. And I just want to do all my thank yous now because we're about to run out of time here. I want to thank Angie D and Antonio Ortiz. They're back in Berkeley at the Mothership. They're on the other end of this equipment, putting it out to the masses so people at home could hear. And I want to thank Keith Edwards. He's out there in the crowd. Thank you, Keith. Give Keith a big hand. And I want to thank my mom, my wife, everybody that's graduated from Live Oak. Everybody that's out here. We got a big crowd out here. And I also want to thank our production and technical interns. And they are Telemana. These people you see sitting on the blankets around you, we came early today and set up all this equipment. That's Carl. Raise your hand, Carl. And behind him is Courtney. And there's Jane right there with them. Melody. We got Golda right over here. We got Carla. Renee, Lamont, Lindsay, Mickey, thank you all for coming. And that wraps it up for our show tonight. Let's can we go out with one more beat by John Mixon? That'd be number 5, 6. So this is another John Mixon beat. So you guys all know John Mixon. Or anyone that goes to the school, you all know John Mixon. So let's take it out with that beat, and thank you all for coming. Oh, welcome back again. I'm sorry, but I wanted to announce that tomorrow, May 30th, the East Side Arts Alliance is sponsoring the Malcolm X Jazz Arts Festival, and the festival runs from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. in San Antonio Park. I believe that's in Berkeley, right? Oakland. Okay. San Antonio Park in Oakland, 18th Avenue and Foothill Boulevard. Come out and check that out all day tomorrow. All of us will be there recording and putting out sound, so go check that out. And let's send it back to that Oh, and don't forget to check out our website, firstvoicemap.org. We're going to post pictures there and blog and a lot of information. And so stay tuned for La Onda Bajita, and thanks for coming.
Civicor Elementary School is pleased to present our fifth annual gala and silent auction fundraiser, Caribbean Beat. This benefit to support the arts and service learning programming of the school will be held Saturday night, May 30th, from 7 to 10 at St. Columbus Church Hall, 6401 San Pablo Avenue at Alcatraz in Oakland. Tickets are $20 per person at the door. The silent auction will feature artwork donated by local artists, restaurant and theater vouchers, tropical food and cocktails, and cool Caribbean vibes care of local DJs. For more information, go to www.civicorps-elementary.org.